We do have some news.
Here we go.
Jane Slater tweeting this moments ago back in Oxnard for Cowboys camp on Wednesday and had a few new details on the contract front. I'm told the team has generous offers on the table for their quarterback, running back, and wide receiver, putting each one in the top five highest paid at their position. Jane continues on Twitter over at SlaterNFL. Additionally, I'm told they're ready and willing to get the deals done, but if the two sides can't agree on numbers that make more sense, the Cowboys are prepared to play this season with each player on a prove-it deal. Sean, thoughts on this?
I mean, it makes sense from the Cowboys' perspective. Look, you want to lock all three of these guys up, so why wouldn't you give them a great offer? I think when you look at Zeke not being there, I mean, I think to me that just kind of hurts that whole relationship. Like, you know, Dak wants a new contract too, but he's there practicing. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I think this is maybe one of those cases where as soon as one guy signs, the other dominoes will fall. But these are the new triplets, right? We talk about Emmitt, yeah. Irv, and Troy. I mean, this is what we could be looking at for the future of the star for years to come.
I don't think it's that shocking that they would get top five the way the market's going. So then what does that mean? Well, it still means a possibility he's the fifth highest paid quarterback in Dak Prescott, and that's still below Carson Wentz. And sure. Guess what? Mm-hmm. Jared Goff will sign a deal a week later, and he'll sign one that's more than both of them. So then suddenly you're the sixth, and maybe another guy, the seventh. I mean, Jane's spot on here in that the Cowboys are going to, you know, make generous offers, but they didn't say the top highest paid. You know, Jane's not saying we're paying him more than Russell Wilson or Aaron Rodgers. And at the end of the day, these agents do not like to be embarrassed. And if you're Todd France, who's Dak Prescott's agent, you don't want two other quarterbacks in the same draft class, Carson Wentz and Jared Goff, to make more than your guy, who you think is the quarterback of America's team. So, look, are they willing to go? I don't think these players are going to necessarily bend over. Okay, oh, definitely. Let me break my back and get there in camp. Top five, yeah. All three guys should be paid top five.
But maybe if you're Dak, you say, you're Todd France. I'm Dak Prescott. Like, I want to be a Cowboys quarterback for life. They gave me a top five offer. Maybe I should take this. It seems a little too neat and symmetrical. Like, the report is great because it lines up. All three are going to be top five. And you might think, well, go get it. But then if you're Zeke, you're like, no. I want to be the number one paid highest. I have a very limited shelf life right now. It's August 6th. We don't got a game for another month. So back to the drawing board, guys. It's encouraging, but this is far from over. Those guys could easily refuse those offers.
More on this throughout the morning here. Go ahead.
Yeah, I was going to say, especially with contracts nowadays, the guaranteed money, the incentives, there's so mm-hmm. much language going into that. So to just say, hey, we offer generous offers.
Yeah, what else you
got?
It
does sound like posturing.
Yeah.
And I think with Zeke, given his background and his history with what's going on.
Yeah.
There's a lot of language that needs to be in there. When it comes to guaranteed money, if you've got somebody that is kind of flying off the wall a little bit, I mean, he's in Cabo right now for crying out
right.
loud. So, of course, we're going to have some added language in that. It's not always cut and dry. Right.
If they all get broke off, what does it mean for Jalen Smith and other guys?
Yes.
They're not the only three dudes that need to get paid.
Break them off,
squad. Though if they are top five and they get this done, that team is scary in 2019 going into preseason action.